Pan those eyeshadows might be a little bit of a loose term for this update today, but you know what? Progress is progress. I still have some progress to share with you, but I always pride myself on having at least one rollout every single update. Unfortunately, today is not one of those days. It's very, very rare on my channel. However, I have loved working with this color story. I am still going strong with it. I've just been really, really overwhelmed with eyeshadows recently. You may be aware that I am starting to phase out eyeshadows from other project pans just so I can get even more amazing progress in projects like this, like Pan That Palette, like Level Up, you know the drill. So today is my Pan Those eyeshadows update. I have four eyeshadows to share with you today, three of which are on my eyes today. But just before we do jump into the video, if you have not already, you know what to do, like and subscribe. I upload every single day so you will not get bored here on my channel. I love project panning and bright, fun, colorful makeup. Today, I don't know if you can see, I've got a teal wing on. I love this look. I think this look is so cute and it's like very work appropriate, if it wasn't for all the glitter, of course. But I had to put glitter on, you know me. So I'm just gonna jump straight into it, I think, and I'm gonna go just in no particular order. I'm just gonna share the shadows with you because, as I said, there's not much progress this month, unfortunately. I did try and push this video back as much as possible, but you will see later in the video, there's not really much point. So the first eyeshadow that I'm going to talk about today is Venus. This is my single eyeshadow. I always like to roll in at least one single eyeshadow to this project just to stop my singles collection getting neglected. And as you can see, this is what it looked like last month. It is this beautiful pinky red to orange yellow duochrome. It is from the Pastel Roses. I absolutely love that brand, we all know. It had a little bit of a dip in it last month, but nothing too serious. And this is what it looks like today. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to see, the dip has got a little bit deeper, but really not much at all. We are nowhere near pan yet. I have used this 2 times this month for a total of 5 uses in the project. 2 times is not enough for pan. We all know that. That is not quite enough. I'm hoping that the duochrome can come across on camera. It's so difficult to try and get duochromes on camera, but this is really beautiful and I've actually found a look that I really, really like with this eyeshadow, and it's very work appropriate as well. My office is very, very lenient when it comes to eyeshadow and makeup, which I'm so thankful for. Obviously, I'm not going in big blue cut creases, but this look that I did at work, it has this on the lid and it has my Modern Renaissance in the crease. It just has red ochre blended out with a blending shade, and it is a really, really nice work look. So hopefully I'm going to be able to do that look a lot more often. If that's like my dedicated work look, then maybe I'll be able to get some really, really good progress on this over the next month. I really need to step up eyeshadows in the next month, and again, that is a massive reason that I have cut out a lot of eyeshadows in other project pans, just because I can feel my eyeshadow-based projects suffering because of it, and I don't want that. So yeah, it's a nice shade. I'm actually really liking reds and not pinky reds. That's the thing, I like reds. Red ochre blended out with just a blending shade, a beige, light white blending shade. It doesn't turn it too pink, which I like. I hate when reds lean pink. I want a red, and that red ochre is a red. My background is literally pissing me off so much, oh my god! Bear with me. This is like the 10th time today. I swear to god. Stay there! Okay, moving on. We fixed it. I like this shade. I was really nervous when I first rolled it in. All of these shades, well, most of these shades are randomized, but I was really, really scared to roll it in because I'm not a warm tone lover. You can probably tell from my look today. But now that I've found a way that I enjoy this, I'm a lot more confident. So staying in, just like the rest. And hopefully we can get more use next month. Okay, next is from my huge Carnival XL Pro palette. You guys know I love this palette so much. And this shade, I do actually really love it as well, even though I've barely used it, which is So annoying. But this is the shade Inspire, and it is a shimmery, taupey shade, which I love. I love taupes. You guys know cool tone taupes are the loves of my life. I absolutely adore them. And you can see on screen now what this shade looks like last month. I'd used it 6 times last month, so that was good. But we've actually only halved it this month to 3 uses. And this is what it looks like today. Probably not much difference at all. There is a tiny bit of a dip in this, but really nothing to write home about. And I'm really disappointed with this one. I really thought that I would use it a lot more, but I have not. This shade is so nice. It's definitely my ideal everyday shade. So I just don't know why I haven't been reaching for it. I really don't know. I think maybe it's because I've been working so hard on trying to finish my Modern Renaissance, and that has 4 very warm tone shades left in it. So trying to incorporate this is a little bit tricky. I don't know. Maybe that's why. But I love this shade. I forgot to swatch again. Oh my God. Okay, here we have Venus and Inspire swatched out on my hand here. Beautiful shades, love them both. 3 uses this month for a total of 9 uses in the project. I am not happy with that. I want to hit pan on this, but I don't know why I can't. It is really, really annoying me. I'm just in this block right now with panning eyeshadows, and I really want to get out of it. But this is, of course, staying in the project. I do like to pair it with Pug in my Pan That palette. So I don't know, hopefully we can get some use on it, because Jesus Christ, I need to step it up. And I know I'm going to say that so many times in this video, but I'm genuinely like annoyed at myself because I don't know what happened this month. Normally my Pan Those Eyeshadows updates are so goddamn good. Not this month. Okay, next is the shade Mulberry, and this was a new shade in last month. This is what it looked like. It was from the ABH Soft Glam palette, and I don't think it had ever been used when I rolled it in, which is very scary, but also very, very exciting. You're seeing what it looked like last month. Pretty untouched, absolutely no use on it. Maybe I'd used it once in the past. And this is what it looks like today. You are probably going to be looking at this screen going, I cannot tell a difference. There are some very, very fine brush strokes in this. And there is that joke in the panning community that Anastasia Beverly Hills shades are so easy to hit pan on. This is made of something else. This is the Realgar of the Soft Glam palette, because this shade is so difficult to hit pan on. When I rolled this in, I was like, easy. ABH, I'll have that done in no time. I've used this 5 times. You can barely see a brush mark on it. This is so firmly pressed, and I'm a little bit scared. I am wearing this today, and I am actually wearing Inspire as well on the center of my lid, just underneath all my glitters. Mulberry is actually on the outer and inner corners. You can't really see it too much. I did want the glitter to be like the focus of this look, but I am wearing it today. I've worn it to work. I've worn it with Venus as well. I had to think about that then. It goes really, really well with Venus. It's definitely more of a warm tone brown, but it can also go with more taupey cool tone browns. I do have it with Pug from my Pan That palette today, which is a very, very cool tone taupe. So it's very versatile. I'm very glad about that. In the pan, it looks very, very red, but on the eyes, it's quite nice. It's quite neutral. But yeah, I've used it 5 times. You cannot tell at all. I'm very scared. It is a neutral shade, so I'm like, oh, it's fine. I'll be able to hit pan on it, but this is gonna take a while, guys. This is gonna take a while. I do have a 15 use rollout rule as well. If I use a shade 15 times and I'm nowhere near pan, I can choose to roll it out. I think this might be one of those shades, because I do have some deep browns in my Pan That palette that I do wanna finish, and I don't wanna dedicate the whole year to just panning this one shade in my Pan Those Eyeshadows. It's difficult, oh my God. All these other shades in this palette that I've hit pan on have been really easy. ABH mattes normally are very, very easy to hit pan on, very easy to finish. This is made of something else, as I said, it's the Realgar of the soft glam. And finally, the shade that I'm wearing as my wing today. This is my favorite shade in this project so far. This is the shade Axis from the Subculture palette, another ABH shade. And as you can see from the progress pictures last month, it is this beautiful teal, like deep matte teal shade, and it is so pretty. I love it so much. I have only used this 3 times though this month, and I do think it is because I have been working a lot. It is pretty hard to incorporate it into looks. This is what it looks like this month. Hopefully you can see there is a little bit of a dip in the middle of it. I do often use a precise brush when I use this shade, so the dip is going to be quite concentrated, but I think this is probably going to be our next pan. Hopefully you have been able to see from the progress pictures there. This is what it looks like swatched out. It is on my wing today. I have really liked this as a wing, and I have used it as a wing in 2 looks. 2 out of the 3 looks have been wings. This was the 3rd look that I did with it. I absolutely love it. I paired it with my Pan Mat palette and it went really, really well. I'm using it just in the crease, along with a few other blue tones as well. The dip is quite deep. I am gonna try and have this pan by next month. This is gonna be my main goal. I don't think it's gonna be too difficult. Hopefully you can see the dip there. It is a beautiful shade. I love playing with blue eyeshadow in my like down chill time. Blue eyeshadow is the way that I love to go. Blue is my happy color. We've said this so many times on my channel. If you're new, I love blue eyeshadow. I love taupes and I love blues. They are my 2 babies. So this one should be quite easy to hit pan on. It's going to be my focus shade this month. I'm going to double down on this and I'm going to make sure that I have pan on this for next update. So these are the 4 shades. A little bit disappointing, I know, no rollouts. I always get in my head about things like this. I always want to have rollouts for you guys. I always want to be like the best I can possibly be. But I am on the journey to kind of understand I don't need to go above and beyond every month. I can have a chill month, it's okay. And I hope you share that thought. Please, don't be mean. I am definitely taking the time to wean out the vast amount of eyeshadow that I am panning. I get excited in projects like Pantasy and Deck of Panning, and every single prompt I think, what eyeshadow can I roll in? And I need to stop that. I am weaning eyeshadows out because projects like this are suffering, and that's not good. That is not good at all. So let me know, what are some looks that you would do with these eyeshadows? Maybe I'll challenge myself and do a look with all of them. That would be really, really fun. Let me know if you want me to do that. And with that being said, this is the end of this update, guys. I hope you did enjoy it. Again, no pans, but I'm okay with that. I'm not really, but I'm telling myself that, okay? I hope you all have an absolutely incredible day. Like and subscribe, and I will see you tomorrow for a brand new video. Bye-bye!